doing comedy here at Finest City instead of doing other things, so welcome. We have a very special night tonight. We have, coming up a little later on this evening, we have a lot of new teams are performing this evening. We have Gals and Dolls, which will be doing some musical improv for you tonight. We have the graduates, a new team, and we have another team. I can't remember, to provide you the name?
Brian Malaga and the Malagas.
Brian Malaga and the Malagas. There's some really fun things coming up for you this evening on this Sunday evening. And I really appreciate you all being out here on a Sunday evening. Always depended on the kindness of strangers. Like you. Our first guest coming to the stage tonight, they met suddenly one summer at Camp Yosemite where they were studying the genre, and together they formed a team based on Tennessee Williams plays. Get my jokes now, everybody? Okay, oh, there they are. All right, so put your hands, get your hands hotter than a cat on a hot tin roof. Give it up for the Infirmary Players!
We are the Infirmary Players, and tonight you have a very special privilege of seeing us perform a full improvised play for you in the style of good old Tennessee Williams. And the only things we'll need from y'all in order to get started is, first, if you could give us an adjective, you know, like a describing word.
Trouble.
Fluffy. Next, from someone over here, what is something you would find in your grandmother's attic?
Wedding dress.
Thank you. The Infirmary Players present the Fluffy Wedding Dress.
I hate things that smell nice.
But I've been cutting them for your birthday.
My birthday deserves things like diamonds and pearls and fancy things, Rose.
Well, I'm very sorry, but you know I'm not able to hold a job, so I have no money, so I have to give you things from the heart and the garden.
Well, sometimes a sister would like her sister, regardless of their imperfections, to give them something special, something fancy.
Well, I know I'm not perfect, but just please take these roses as a gift from your imperfect little sister who could never be as beautiful or as complete as you.
I will take these roses because they are beautiful, like me. And when it comes time for your birthday, I will give you a rock that's been pounded by a rock.
Right. I just thought you'd be kindly to me because you know how my bone leg affects.
It's not my fault that you fell out of a wagon.
But Gwendolyn, don't forget who pushed that wagon down the hill.
It's not my fault that your arms are so tiny that you rolled on out and hit every tree down the hill.
But Gwendolyn, I was just a baby of 12 months. Oh,
but Rose, babies are supposed to be strong.
I know, I guess I'll never be as strong as you and never have a handsome boyfriend as you would.
Fiance. Oh, Rose.
I'm sorry, I forgot.
You always forget, don't you?
I do. How about I get you another rose?
Wow.
Careful with those roses. You might just slip down the hill again.
Oh, sure. You take the blooming ones. I'll leave the wilted ones for myself.
That's perfect.
I don't need a full bloom.
How my girls doing, my beautiful birthday girl and my other? Wonderful, Mama. Those roses will look beautiful on the dining table as we celebrate the day of your birth and the announcement of your special day. Your wedding. If only I could look forward to that with you.
It ain't right.
I know, his nose is dirty.
It ain't right, boy.
I know, his nose is dirty.
If you know, why are you doing it wrong, boy?
Because all you gave me is a muddy cloth.
God damn it, Cotton, if you weren't my first son, I would have balled you up like the trash you are and thrown you out years ago.
Sorry, Father.
Can't even clean a damn horse using a muddy cloth. You too stupid to clean a horse, boy.
I keep trying, Papa.
Trying. Trying's having the intention to fail, Cotton. Didn't I teach you nothing? About nothing?
I believe so, Pop.
You don't clean this damn horse, we ain't gonna be able to go to the birthday party tomorrow. And you don't want to embarrass this whole family again, do you?
Just like you always say, Papa, I am the embarrassment to the family.
At least you live your truth, boy. You embarrassing pile of dung. Can't even clean a goddamn four-legged animal. Why don't you get down on all fours, see if it'll help. Maybe you get on the same level.
Okay, Bob.
God damn it, boy, I didn't mean that. You have embarrassed this family for the last time, Cotton.
Do you believe in me now, Daddy? Is that why? I can only embarrass this family one more time?
You try embarrassing this family one more time, you see what's gonna happen to you.
Is it gonna be a good thing, Pa?
Maybe it won't be. This here Clydesdale will be turning into glue next year. It's gonna be you, Cotton. Cotton glue, I'll be the first one in the town to have it. Won't be worth a damn, probably won't hold anything together.
I think it's illegal to make glue out of human body.
I am just in a tizzy getting this party ready.
I know,
there
that girl.
There is so much to do.
That girl has such high expectations.
Absolutely.
Of a party.
And we are here as newcomers to this community, and we've got to make an impression.
We need to impress them.
Absolutely.
We are building our fortune, our future, on establishing the best parties in this town.
Absolutely. Oakendale Wood has never seen the likes of our party planning.
No, they don't know what is going to hit them.
Let's start over. We're gonna make it big this time.
Yes. We are not going back. We're not gonna have the same problems we had before.
No, and I'm sorry. I don't know how many times I have to apologize for that evening.
We've been through that. We've been through that. I have my own apologies to make too, Beulah. We're new.
Yes.
We're new people.
It's a fresh start.
Fresh start. New people. New names.
Yes.
New town.
New identities. New parties.
It's all new.
Gee,
Carlisle.
Yes.
We weren't expecting you.
Why are you here?
That's right, why are you here?
Well, I thought that maybe we should talk a little bit about this birthday party / engagement announcement, since it is your son marrying my daughter.
Unfortunately.
You sure you want to go through with this?
Well, you're lucky to have someone like my beautiful girl.
You underestimated our son.
I heard he can't even clean a horse.
Marguerite, don't you defend that ball of dump.
Don't be rough to him. He's just a little boy.
Little boy? He's bigger than I am.
Not my baby, okay?
Yeah, you would give birth to that.
God damn this damn Mary York.
Told you not to do it. Stand there at the altar,
no
I said, I looked
no
at
choice.
You, I said, don't do it. You don't have the nerve. And look at you, living up to my expectations. I'm sorry, Madam Carlisle, you have to see this right now.
It's given me second thoughts about going through with this, letting my daughter get into this family.
What was your first thought when you saw that boy? Can't even clean a hole.
She said she loved him.
Oh.
But my husband was stupid, too. He was stupid, and he died. Now I'm all alone with my two girls. I need a man on our estate, even if he can't clean a four-legged animal. But we need a man.
Well, you know, one thing I did not do is marry for love. I ain't as stupid as your dead husband.
You've got strong arms.
Because I always have to clean the horses with my boy.
You two have no shame.
Oh, please, woman. God.
I've been seen around the town.
Whose fault is that?
You two have been sneaking out.
It ain't sneaking if it's out in the open.
It's such a disdainful.
Well, where else am I going to get it, huh? From you? Ha! Like I need another ball of cotton in my life.
Give me something I got. All the potato soup?
Well, it ain't enough.
Honey, a man wants more than potatoes.
To see you before such a big event. I just couldn't stay away. As you know, my sister Rose has to come with me everywhere. But one day, you're softer than I expected today.
I'm sorry, my dad just tenderize that arm. It keeps hitting me in the morning.
Once you live on our estate, your daddy will never lay a finger on you again. I'll be sure of that.
I like that.
Gwendolyn, are you going to be sitting there all day, or are you going to scoot out of the way so I can scrub those floors clean of all that mud you done tracked in?
Don't get up.
If you're talking to me, I can't.
I'm gonna wear something so pretty tonight.
Oh, I'm gonna like that.
I'm gonna look like a big old cake.
Cake's my favorite. I like chocolate cake with the vanilla buttercream.
Mm. Your breast looks like buttercream.
Maybe you'll be hungry later.
Oh!
Don't you hear the tea kettle spitting out its noise in the kitchen?
Yeah, I feel like you should go do something about that.
I'm so busy with these here floors. Mm. How about you run and get us some tea? I'm very parched.
Should I?
No. We're going to stay right here.
Okay.
We'll just let it whistle. Whistle real old loud until eventually Rose will find a way to muster up stand up and go take care of it, because I'm clearly busy with the love of my life thinking about buttercream.
I'm getting real hungry now.
Hey, how do you do it? Huh? Tell me. I just put on parties, that's all. Make the arrangements, you bring in some balloons.
That's one big party to you.
As a matter of fact, it is. That's my job.
I got a ranch to look after, a lame duck of a son to raise, and bring to this here birthday / wedding announcement.
That good looking guy Cotton, that your son?
Good looking!
That is quite of a hunkin' looking boy.
Look like God dragged him through the drive twice.
Guess it's all in the eye of the beholder, but you know, I'd be proud if I had a son that was looking like him.
Oh, come on! What do you know? Ain't never had a kid yourself.
I ain't never had a kid, no.
What's the matter? That thing don't work?
No, that works.
What the hell? Why are you looking at me? I didn't mean for... Go, you throw on your party as your fancy party. That's why I see you having so much glitter at your damn party.
Glitter makes a party. Let me send you the bill.
Oh. Think I can't cash that bill? Cash far larger bills than your little tea party.
That's good. I like to have a customer.
Why do you say that?
Resources. Customers with large resources behind them.
You just worry about throwing my damn idiot son and that beautiful little fiance of his an engagement party and his birthday party they can remember.
Done. It will be a party that this town, like this town, has never seen before.
Why are you getting all close to me for?
Why? You don't like it?
I don't think so.
Miss Carlyle. I just want to go over a couple of details of your beautiful daughter's event. Well, now, will salmon jello with olives do?
is that how they've been doing it?
Oh, it's all the rage in a housekeeping magazine.
Well, if that's what it... we want to impress the town.
Yes, up north, they do that, and then they do a pearl, onion, and mayonnaise casserole. It is to die for.
Well, I suppose if that's how it's done, I want everyone to be talking about this for all their days.
Oh, they will be talking about this. They will be talking.
Yes.
I just have to say, if I had a daughter left, if I had a daughter as beautiful as yours,
I believe
the party to be.
Did you say a daughter left?
No. I just meant, if someone so special as your daughter has this one day to have a birthday and an announcement of an engagement, it's got to be pristine.
Yes, yeah, that's why I hired you.
It's got to have the veneer of opulence.
Yeah.
Even though maybe behind it, this schmugamagug is not good fun. Everyone will forget the wedding. Everyone will forget the marriage, but they will remember the engagement party.
Yes. Oh, I'm beginning to have second thoughts. So maybe you're right. Maybe he isn't the right one for her. Maybe I am doing wrong by my daughter. It's the perfect party to disannounce their engagement.
What the hell are you wearing, boy?
I'm wearing pants and I have a balloon.
What do you put the pants on up top for?
Because it fits all the way up here.
Too rough in him. We should have been a lot rougher a long time ago.
It's my sweet little boy.
Sweet little, look at him, woman! Do you not see the same size person I see?
He's a boy, married.
If Gwendolyn had any sense, she'd dump him like the washed-up cotton ball he is.
He deserves so much better than that girl.
He deserves better than you as a mother, that's for sure. Or else what?
Unless...
Or else I...
Boy, you don't back the hell up right now. You're gonna be sleeping in mud.
I already do.
That is your choice, you idiot.
I like it. You can't threaten me with mud. You have to mud my friend. Mud my comfort zone.
Mud ain't no friend, you idiot. What?
I can't do anything to tell you!
What the hell did you just say to me?
The fluffy dress is looking so good on you.
I've never seen anything outside of underneath New York and miles from New York like that.
Honey, I don't know what she just said, but I think it was nice.
Are you sure you want cotton of all the people?
I've never wanted cotton more than anything in the entire world. Just think about all the liquids it can sap up.
He's a Christian.
Honey, have you been exchanging fluids?
We haven't even made the announcement yet.
I should hope so.
Never.
Otherwise, that dress will have to be fluffier to make up for a little rider.
Rose, what do you think of how I look?
I don't care how you look. I don't think you love cotton like I love cotton. You don't even know his favorite color. It's the color of the sky. You don't even know his favorite animal. It's the one with four legs.
You going through with this?
There's nothing that will stand in my way. Nothing at all. For I'm going to marry Cotton.
I am going to stand in your way.
And then I'm going to stand in her way.
Then I'm going to cut through you like a piece of butter knife.
Piece of butter knife?
Yeah, that's right. I said that.
Maybe you should marry that boy.
In just a moment, he's gonna walk in and all the guests are gonna be here, and Rose isn't, cause I'm gonna also smash her with a butter knife. And my mama isn't gonna be here, cause I'm also gonna smash her with a butter knife. And I'm gonna go rogue! I'm gonna go insane!
Sounds like you are well on your way.
I heard yelling up. Yes, I love her with all my heart.
You ain't got a heart, boy.
He does.
It's beating right now. I wouldn't be alive without a heart, Bob.
What?
Said he's being smart, Alec.
I think I'm having a
Good. About time something good happened in this town.
Stop talking like that to Mom. Mom.
Mom, he's died.
Great, I don't have to do anything. I'm gonna marry you if it means I have to turn into a murderer.
What?
Isn't that beautiful?
That's scary.
Look at you, Con. You really done it for yourself.
Oh!
God damn it, boy!
All right!
Hit on the shoulder. That's all you done for.
I can't deal with it anymore.
Bringing more shit into our house.
You are the shit. I mean the bad kind.
See, everyone has arrived. I have the salmon jello here.
Carlisle.
Yes.
Finally, you came here.
It's my home.
Mitch, thank you for coming to your home.
Who's the dumb one now, Dad?
You still are, boy.
Hey, oh. I'll hit you again. Just as hard.
Oh, she'll and do so. It too.
That's on the party. I've got the glitter. Let's cheer up a bit. What the hell is that supposed to mean? It's what makes the party.
This is the worst goddamn party I've ever paid for in my life.
Keep it going, Joe. Who's on next? I forgot to look.
Graduates!
Please keep it going, Flora!